Hello, I'm Ehsan Saleh, the lead TA for Applied Machine Learning at the University of Illinois. So hello, everyone. I want to start by showing an example of one of our Applied Machine Learning course assignments and show you the breakdown of that assignment. We typically break each of these long course projects that are called assignments into 5 to 10 modules, or as we call them, tasks. Each of these tasks include a couple lines of code so that the students wouldn't have a hard time identifying problems within them, and they would be atomic enough for those purposes. One thing that I want to emphasize here is the importance of the proper amount of documentation. The first thing that we do for the students is provide them with an assignment summary where we describe the big picture and what are we going to do. We also sometimes for the more advanced assignments, we brush up on the math inside the Jupyter notebook just to help the students refresh their memory about them and also help get the nomenclature correctly throughout the assignment. For the most advanced assignments, we may even have to provide the students with detailed implementation guides. For each of the tasks that we ask the students to implement, we also provide them with a set of detailed task descriptions, detailing what the input and output arguments are supposed to be and what each of them mean. Finally, for the more enthusiastic and less patient kind of students, we provide them with input-output doc strings, which are very common for Python documentations. So here we describe in a very short way what the input and the output are supposed to be. Now, let's take a look at the process from a learner's perspective. So let's say we have a student. A student is supposed to be implementing some function. As soon as the student produces some code, they're going to run it against a single dummy test case for just checking the input and the output. Those kind of tests are mostly like all zeros or all ones. So these are very trivial kind of tests just to see whether you're getting a vector out or stuff like that. Next, as soon as the student passes the first step, they're going to test their code against a public input-output file consisting of many tests and their corresponding reference outputs so that they could essentially see if their code is producing the right kind of functionality. So as you can see, this public file could include a lot of tests and their corresponding pre-computed reference values so that the student's implementation could be compared against them. As soon as the student finishes the second step, they will be submitting their assignments and our auto grader will run some hidden test cases and provide them with a grade. Now, all the steps that we talked about so far, they don't gauge the student's understanding of what happened at the end of the day. For example, we want to make sure that the student has the right theoretical understanding of the output plots or figures. We evaluate the student's understanding about those aspects through Coursera's quizzes. Now let's take a look at some of the common student issues. One of them, the very first one, is that the students may be producing incorrect output data structures. For example, in Python, many of you may already know that we have lists and tuples and arrays, so the student could be producing one instead of the other. The second kind of common mistake is to produce the incorrect output data type or the incorrect casting. For example, you could produce a Boolean instead of an integer or instead of a floating point number. Another kind of common mistake is to confuse the array shapes and dimensions. For example, the student may be producing a row vector instead of a column vector or vice versa. So those are another kind of common mistakes. Finally, the student could be producing a buggy implementation that causes their code to be crashing on some of the input of some of the test cases. Now, let's take a look at the first one and how our own API helps the students identify the problem. So let's say that we have a student's implementation that produces the wrong kind of output data structure. This is an example of the diagnosis message that our API produces and tells the students about. For example, as you can see, it tells the student that they're producing a tuple output. However, the reference solution is actually a NumPy array. And the message is very clear. And this is very different from the typical Python tracebacks that are not as informative or helpful as you can see here. Also, to help the student identify the problem, we also let them know about the specific problematic test case arguments that caused this issue to appear in the first place. This goes a long way towards helping the students debugging their code and making this experience more pleasant rather than shooting in the dark. The same kind of discussion goes, for example, the incorrect type of casting that the students could be producing, or for example, confusing the array shapes and dimensions, and the messages are very clear in those cases. It's also common for the students to produce a buggy implementation where their code could be crashing on a certain set of input arguments. So as you can see, here's an example diagnosis message, and we also output the problematic test case arguments that caused their code to crash in the first place, again, to help them identify the problem.